We've got more ice hockey coming up in the British Championship today. That's the Fife Flyers against Murrayfield Racers. Before we do that, let's have a look at the comparative lifestyles of a couple of stars of the game of ice hockey. Tony Hand, who we'll see in action for Murrayfield later on this afternoon, is a British star, but that's nothing in comparison to the world number one, the acknowledged world number one of ice hockey, Wayne Gretzky, who plays his ice hockey in Canada. Reporting for us, Kevin Crosgrove on the other side of the Atlantic and Archie McPherson here.
Edinburgh was captured by tourists ages ago, but although they regard this view from the castle as the definitive statement on the city, a lot of the dynamic detail of the Scottish capital eludes them. This is a dynamic young man. Admittedly, he looks fairly anonymous in an Edinburgh street, but then only Gene Kelly would make something of a walk on a pavement. Even if we follow him to his work, that gargantuan plant, most modern in Fife, where gas is converted into pounds and pens, he is but another of the many apprentices grafting away to make a living in an area where employment can sometimes be a privilege rather than a right. To be honest, even some of his mates have been slow to recognize his nocturnal activities. So far, so mundane. But then, veering towards the midnight chimes, the transformation. The dungarees give way to uniform, the apprentice climbs into the apparel of gladiator. Tony Hand boy in the street becomes Tony Hand ice hockey scoring phenomenon, the greatest homegrown prospect in the business. Murrayfield Raiders have landed in the playoffs, greatly helped by the prolific scoring touch of Hand, who's piled up more goals than any other homebred player. Now, every ice hockey man is aware that the public sometimes think the sport is a mere artistic version of tribal warfare. And in asking Canadian Gord McDougall if that image still persisted, we became aware he'd been asked that before.
Maybe 10 years ago, that was what was happening in the game. 10 years ago, they were going more for the bigger goony guys. But nowadays, they're going for the young skaters and all the good skaters, and the technique with the puck is what really matters right now. You know, that stuff there has no bearing on the game anymore at all.
But you would admit that some of the public like to see a bit of fight in Niagara.
Yeah, most, you know, they like to see a little bit. That's all been part of the game for years, though.
Appealing though that may be to the bloodseekers, the game in fact transcends all of that. The coach, not surprisingly, is a Canadian, Alec Dampier, who isn't merely engaged in raising skill level, but of constantly promoting an infant sport.
Go, Paul.
Alec, well, how long is it that you can take to develop a player who's hardly ever skated before and develop him into an ice hockey player of tolerable standard?
I think that really depends on each person's individual skill, but someone like Tony Hand, who's one of the best in the country right now, probably didn't start playing until he was 9 years old, and Tony's now 17, so, but he's an exceptional case. I think most people take a little longer than that.
He obviously has natural ability.
Oh, yes, he's very, very talented. You know, good eye-hand coordination.
Tony, it's 10:30 at night. You've just got an ice. All the people are off now. It's been a very long day for you. Is this what it's like every day?
Yeah, this morning we got up at 6:15, started work, 7:30. Finished at 3:00. Got home and here now. So
it must take a lot out of you, though.
Oh, it tires you, especially if standing on your feet all day working. And you're here training, and you get home late at night, up early in the morning.
Well, when will you finish tonight, for example?
Tonight, about 11:30. The time we get to bed, it's just about 1 o'clock.
How many hours sleep do you get?
Tomorrow, about 6-7 hours.
Okay. typically, I mean, in a week?
In a week average, really. Lucky for 5.5.
Their loyal band of supporters, about 2,000 strong, need steady nerves to face up to the prospect of watching Murrayfield play Durham.
We got Crapper going with the puck right away. Everybody understand? Tony? Make sure you understand what we're doing here. I don't want Crapper loose on the far side. You circle the wrong way.
The playoffs are only a game away. And on a day of intense commitment, the enthusiasm of the crowd rubs off. Murrayfield gone to win this 6-4. But more importantly, the public interest has been rekindled. And yet the old world has many lessons to learn from that other world where ice hockey is less a sport than an addiction.
For 5 months each year, Mother Nature provides Canada with complimentary skating rinks. More than 100 years ago, a pond like this was the birthplace of Canada's game.
Carlisle takes a check from Lindstrom, gets it to McLean, to Mother Nature!
The country's longest running radio and television program is Hockey Night in Canada. Today, ice hockey's most competitive league is made up of teams from both Canada and America. The game is watched by millions and dominated by one man.
Gets it ahead from Gretzky, Gretzky is breaking in, Gretzky scores!
If ever a game and a country were made for each other, it's Canada and Wayne Gretzky. He began playing in his family's backyard. He was a star when he was 8, and at the ripe old age of 18, became an instant multi-millionaire when he signed a lifetime contract with the Edmonton Oilers.
The game has evolved into the way he plays the game. It's a very wide open, offensive minded hockey game, and he's just the best in the world at it right now.
The mere mortals of the National Hockey League earn an average £100,000 a year, which eases the headache of how to stop Gretzky.
Well, short of nailing their dressing room shut, we have to key on. You have to take away Gretzky's body, you have to anticipate the passes that he may make. Basically have to skate with him.
In his 6 years in the league, Gretzky has broken every scoring record. In a game of relentless speed, he always seems to have time. And if he's not scoring himself, he's setting up goals for others.
I'm not a big person, I'm not a strong person, so I have to try to stay ahead, mentally ahead of the game, and stay one step ahead of the other guys. And the second thing is I utilize everyone on the ice. I use my teammates, my two wingers, I know where they are at all times, and I can tell you where the other team is going to be and where they are at all times, and those are my two strengths.
Introducing a new star, Probe Star!
Okay, let's have a good, nutritious breakfast before we practice.
In addition to his $1 million a year playing salary, the Great One, as he's called, gets another $2 million for being one of advertising's favorite sons.
Right,
Mom?
That's right, Wayne. And you like Pro Stars because your picture's on the box, right?
From autumn to spring, North America's hockey teams crisscross the ice and the continent. Last week, Gretzky's team were in Winnipeg, a city that's the gateway to Canada's prairies. The prairies are peaceful. The hockey rinks aren't.
You scream and you holler and you clap and you stomp and you do everything. Anything to excite the players and get them really going.
It's championship time here. A game that's always hard gets harder.
To be a professional hockey player, you have to realize that it's physical. It's one of the most physical sports in the world, but it's enjoyable.
How do you stay out of the way, though? How do you, because they're obviously
here. If you got a guy 6'4" coming at you, you'd get out of the way quick, too.
The Oilers are the defending champions. In a tight game in Winnipeg the other night, naturally, it was their captain who scored the winning goal.
Close doesn't count. Second is not first. And if you're not first, then you're not the best, and we like being the best, and it's simple as that.
It seems likely that Wayne Gretzky will shepherd his team to another championship.
Well, we knew they were going to play physical. It didn't surprise us that much.
At 24, Canada's most sought-after man has reached the stage where the only standards left to beat are his own.
Sometimes I sit down and think about what I've done in the past and what I've accomplished. And I feel excited about it. I feel happy and proud that I've done it. But then I sit and think that I'd like to do better, so I have a long way to go.
And so, in a much quieter world is 17-year-old Tony Han. And if he keeps his eye on the target, the Kretzky horizon might not seem so far away after all.
And there you see live pictures of the man himself on ice at Wembley this afternoon, where he'll be playing for Murrayfield Racers against Fife Flyers in the British final. Let's join Alan Weeks live.
The grand finale of the 1984-5 season, the Heineken Championship. 48 teams in various divisions of ice hockey in Britain have played this season from Bournemouth in the south to Edinburgh in the north. Premier Division clubs played off for the privilege to be here at Wembley. And it's the two old rivals from the south and north side of the fourth, Fife Flyers and Murrayfield Racers, who will meet in this final. Murrayfield Racers from Edinburgh. Watch out for Murray Hansen in goal, the top goalie in these players with an 86.7% average. And number 21, bottom right there, Chris Cullen, a captain from Western Canada. Gordon McDougall, who you've seen. In America, we scored one goal and five assists yesterday. But watch out, of course, for Tony Hand on the left there and his brother Paul Hand. Tony, 17 years of age, the top British-born player, the second scorer in the league, a superb stick handler. And Paul Hand, his 19-year-old brother, plays on defence. And on occasion, the two of them combine very well. This is Tony just taking it round the defenceman, putting a beautiful pass through to his brother, who knocks it away on the backhand. And Fife Flyers, Andy Donald in the net, under 20 international. But watch out for Ron Plum, number 3, a 34-year-old player coach from North America. And a Kikori-born player, number 14, Andy Linton, right wing. He plays on the right wing with number 9, Danny Brown. Brown is a very good player indeed, third highest scorer in Britain. He comes to Toronto. This is the sort of player he is. He skates very well, skates very fast, takes it through, beats the man, and can always put it away. And he's at centre ice with this man, Dave Stojanovic, 25-year-old Canadian from London, Ontario, the top scorer in Britain with 160 goals and 101 assists for 261 points. He's always in the right place, he's got a tremendous shot, but this is one of his easier ones. This is his 160th goal, and it's simple for Stojanovic. So the team's now ready for the face-off. The semi-final results there, Murrayfield won 13-4, and Fife Flyers won 12-3. So, we've got Alex McWilliam, the referee, about to set this game in motion, the final. And on the left, Murrayfield Racers. On the right, attacking that goal to the left, it's Fife Flyers. Fife in blue and Fife in possession. Into that Murrayfield end right away. Great crowd here at Wembley. It's super to see them back in this stadium. Tony Han in there from the word go, and what a chance that was. Chris Killen on the net. Murrayfield with the pressure on. And Ron Plummet is who turns it away. is. Ron Hahn relieved the pressure by shooting the puck from one end of the rink to the other. You can't do that if both teams are equal strength. You get a face-off back in your own end. Ron Hahn, the player coach for Fife Flyers, a very, very good player. The oldest man in the world, 34 years of age. Great experience. Fife Flyers, of course, have been runner-up in both the Autumn Cup and the Heineken League, so they're looking to go on top. Good pass. Andy Linton. Oh, hit the post! What a let-off that was. Great break by Fife, and bad luck for Linton off the post. In again. Icing. The defender got there first, and so it's going to be a face-off back alongside the Fife Flyers net. Here's Andy Linton. And it hits the right hand post there. That was close indeed. But that's the way Fife Flyers are. They've got some good scorers. They come out very fast. They can turn defense into attack in a matter of 5 or 6 seconds. So, face off just to the left of the Fife Flyers net. Gordon McDougall in the corner there. Jim Pennycook, number 7 for Fife, and that's Gordon McDougall, the American. Had a great game in the semi-finals, setting up 5 goals and scoring one himself. I remember in ice hockey that players get points for an assist if they set up a goal as well as if they score it. Chick Cottrell coming out for Fife Flyers. Around the boards, and the pass out. Turn back in again. Offside. The face off just outside the Murrayfield Racers zone. And here's the Murrayfield coach, Alex Dampier. This is probably his last match with Murrayfield. He's going to join Nottingham next season. In by Stuart Drummond, and now it's Fife who had it in the Murrayfield end. Paul Heavey, good pass. Hay and Duncan McIntyre going really fast, number 10 there for Murrayfield, taken out on the boards. Puck is still loose, but didn't quite get there, so it's going to be an icing. Got to play it before the defenseman. Well, this is really up and down stuff, there's no doubt about that. And we've got great supporters, both from Murrayfield and from Fife, and also a great number of supporters from Durham, the team that won the league, but missed out on this final. So it's Danny Brown now, and Jim Lynch, who's also a Canadian, facing off. 3 imported players on each team, good stuff. Hanson, 86.7. He had 1,547 shots in the league. And a shot on goal is one that would go in if he didn't stop it. Back to the point again. It's loose, it's loose, it's very loose, it's there! Stojanovic, the scorer! No! No, no! The referee looks as though he's called it back. It's possible there was someone in the crease. Let's have a look. There's the shot. Comes in. Now the puck comes loose. It's still there. Yes, there's a player in the crease. You see, you cannot score when there's a player in the crease. So that is taken back. The score is still 0-0. And that was perfectly illustrated. A lot of people have said, what is that crease there for? Well, that's one of the reasons. That's the crease, and the attacking player cannot be in that crease when a goal is scored. Paul Heavey. Oh, good forechecking. Plenty of time for Fife Flyers. Here's Neil Abel. Danny Brown. He's got Stojanovic, Tony, and Danny Brown going in close. He's there! This time it is Danny Brown, the scorer. No doubt about it this time. Danny Brown, number 19. Comes in, brings it around from the right wing position. Notices a left hand shot. Backhand off the skate of Murray Hansen. Brings it round the defenseman, Chris Kellen. And off Murray Hansen's skate. Danny Brown now has sent five flyers on the way. 1-0. Back come Murrayfield. Here's Tony Hand. Being eased off by Gordon Leto. Out they come again. This is Gordon Leto. Good shot, punched away by Murray Hansen. Into the corner. It's a dead puck. And a face-off just alongside that Murrayfield net. Well, it's up and down. Those are the Five Flyer supporters. Remember that famous G block up at Kokori? They're all here, plus their honorary supporters. I'm happy to say I've been made an honorary supporter of G block. So, we've got the face-off. And it's Danny Brown again. Stojanovic this side of the circle. Back to Stojanovic. Across to the point. Ron Plum. Oh! Neatly knocked away by Hansen. He couldn't have much of a sight of it. And again by Neil Abel. Stojanovic in there. Away by Paul Hand. And there's Tony. Now Paul. Paul Hand. The defenseman making a rush. Picked up by Lindsay Lovell, but now dispossessed. And here's Danny Brown. He was really going, but he was taken out of the play. But there is a penalty, high-sticking penalty, prior to that break. And the man who's going to take it take a 2-minute penalty for high sticking. Now, Murrayfield have the power play situation. They have the one man advantage, and they have been extraordinarily good when they've had a power play. In fact, they're the best in the league as far as scoring goals when they have the man advantage. Here's Tony Hand. Shot away by Danny Brown. Oh, it's picked up by Stojanovic. He's in again. Stojanovic missed it. Just slid off his stick. A chance for Marathon to get away, but they're slow on the recovery. Jim Lynch taking his time. Chris Kellen coming through. Kellen in there. Poked away by Andy Donald. And the net, in fact, has come off its moorings. Once the net comes off its moorings, the whistle blows immediately. Obviously, you could not have a solid net there because the players move so fast. If they hit that net, then it would be a very serious injury. So it gives if a player hits it. So Murrayfield in the power play, the man advantage, Danny Brown facing off with Gordon McDougall. Back to the point, off the target, the point again, and once again, Fife's Ron Plum gets it down the rink, takes off the pressure. Paul Pentland. Tony Hand. That's offside. And a very hard body check there by Ron Plum. And a bit pensive, Eric Dampier, thinking well. We've still got 1 minute and 9 seconds of this penalty. How are we going to make it pay? Face-off is in Murrayfield's end. Jack Hay, number 12, back, shot back in, picked up by Chris Kellen. Kellen now, the pass. Gordon McDougall, slap shot, deflected. into the corner. Jack Hay with it. Puck is still loose. Gordon McDougal has it. Now Tony Hamm has it. Back to the point. But it's off. Way, way off. Killen had no chance to get that one. Just about 35 seconds on the penalty. And thus far, Merrifield not getting on top. Jim Lynch, Tony Hand. Tony across. There's Gordon McDougal back to the point, and it bounces over Chris Killen's stick. That's the wide edge for them. Pentland. 15 seconds on the penalty. This is Killen. Didn't get it through. Zajanovic. Well, here's a chance. And Ron Plum just easing the pressure. It's all over. Abel is back on the ice. And so, Andy Linton took it down there. Back come Merrifield. Hey, Lynch. Kept it low, and that net is off its moorings again. In fact, it does look a fraction too loose, because the goalie just fell against the net then, and it came off its moorings. And here's Andy Donald, kicking it away. So far, it's four shots. And that one you saw there for Merrifield. That's the shots on goal so far in this first period. 14 minutes and 34 seconds to play. And the face-off, if the linesman or the referee sees the two players are not lining up properly, he'll get two more players and take the face-off. He pass. Jim Pinnicott taking it down into the corner. Eased out by Paul Heavey. Then by Gordon McDougal. It'll be a face-off. Once the referee cannot see the puck, the puck is frozen against the boards, then it's a whistle. But, in fact, in that little melee, Gordon McDougal has got himself a penalty. He's in the box, and he was holding against the boards, so he'll spend 2 minutes in there for holding. Now, Five Flyers have the power play situation. We'll see how they come off. In yesterday's match, Five Flyers had 5 power play situations, had 5 goals. Well, they're spreading out, and that's what they've got to do. That wasn't far off. Gordonetto keeping it there. Break. Tony Hand slipped. Wasn't tripped. Gordonetto going back with it. Gordonetto shot. Stopped by Hansen. Andy Linton going through there, or trying to go through there. He's trying to get it out in front. Must come back to the point. Almost certainly. Not going too well. There. Stojanovic. That's the shot. It's off the target this time, but the rebound comes out. It's Danny Brown again. Goal number 2 for Danny Brown. Well, it was the shot from Stojanovic. It was kicked away. Here's Stojanovic. This tremendous shot, very fast, went around the back, and there was Brown to flip it back into the net. 2-0 for Five Flyers. So Stojanovic has equaled the Heineken Championship playoff record for points. 27 points, equaled by Durham's Jamie Crapper. Merrifield in possession. Tony Hand. Plum. There's Andy Linton again. It's all about this fella. Big leg. Come from Kripoli. Lindsay Lovell. And the back. And the puck is still loose. Tony Hand has it. Beautiful stick handling. Still has it. Jim Lynch. Lindsay Lovell. Blocked by one of the defensemen. The puck is still bouncing in that five flyers end. Danny Brown, good pass. Didn't quite be accepted by Penny, but it bounced over his stick. Neat turn by Chris Kellen. Kellen then. Here's Neil Label. Gets it out. Kellen, way across the net, looking for Lindsay Lovell. Going the way of five flyers, they're all over there. Plum. Murray Hansen. He was straight at him, but he smothered it because he doesn't want to see any rebounds come out. Here's Ron Plum with the shot. Didn't have to move, but he wanted to smother it. Murray Hansen. Third in the Dungeons, I believe. So, Jim Kelly got number 7 for 5 Flyers, facing off with Gordon McDougall. McDougall there. Now Chris Cullen. It's a penalty. Well, it's Gordon McDougall again. That's his second penalty. McDougall number 7 there. And he tripped the player who went down behind that defenseman. So, once again, 5 Flyers have the power play situation. Didn't make it play last time. The little one goal, but we'll see now if they will add to that. Rebound picked up by Kellen. The pass, but Tony Hand couldn't accept it. Mind you, Merrifield are going to play defensively. The former square again at their own end. Because 5 come out very fast. Decoy players. Gordon Letter. Jim Pennycook. Finds him. Pennycook. Out in front. Netto. Ron Plum keeping it in. Back in the corner. Kellen shooting it out. No whistle here. And it's Neil Abel. 6'1" in Scotland, Scottish born defenseman. Tough character. Here's Ron Plum. Stojanovic. Look at the way that boy is moving, Stojanovic. Picked up by Danny Hand. And then Neil Abel across to Ron Plum. Stojanovic and Heavy were getting a bit mixed up on the boards there. Here's Ron Plum again. Here's Plum. Good shot. And the rebound there. But Chris Kellen stopping Plum getting through for it. Puck is still loose. It's getting a bit hard. It's getting very hard in the corners. Broken up very quickly. And Andy Linton. It's taken out in the ball, against the boards there, but there's no whistle, there's no penalty apart from the frozen puck. 29 seconds, 28 seconds now on the penalty. That's the point, Plum. Goal! Ron Plum, the scorer. Three nil for 5 Flyers. Plum's shot went through a crowd of players there. There's the pass back. Now there's a lot of players between Plum and Hansen. It was there, 3-0. Well, that's 2 power play goals now by 5 Flyers as they take this 3-0. 10 minutes and 5 seconds on the first period. Again, Benson, it's gone through. It's loose. It's still loose. And now it's tapped against the back of the net. Well, there are about three rebounds there from Hansen. And the defenseman was very quick to get it and take it around behind the net and trap it. There's Leto, bounced away. The puck loose, comes back again. And again it comes away. But now they're back in action here. And it's White Flyers really keeping that pressure on Murrayfield. And in front, oh, Gordon Leto with a chance. Pass from Foster. Here's Kellen. Kellen with a quick turn. You hear a slight booing. Chris Kellen is one of the players that the supporters just love to boo. Lansing. McDougall. McDougall in front. Oh, what a chance. Jack Hay had the chance so far of the match as far as Murrayfield's concerned. He was open in front of the net. Jack Hay. He was wide open in front of the net. Here's McDougall, and look at Hay in front of that net. Just flipped it wide. Well, Murrayfield now having a face-off in the 5-end. It hasn't happened too often so far in this period, and there's 9 minutes and 12 seconds to go in this period. Timing is very precise. Every time the play stops, the clock stops. Neil Abel. Net throw, picked up by Andy Linton. Lanovic. Picked up by Danny Brown now. That's Kellen. Trying to flip it away, doesn't get it away. Kellen picked up by Duncan McIntyre. Got McDougall with him. There's McDougall. Come, taking out McDougall. Piper very quick in covering. Lanovic, that's the shot. Stopped by Hansen, but still in that end. No, it's not. That was over the line, and so it'll go face off at the other end of the ring. So, six players on the ice at a time, remember. Bill Minder, two defensemen, three forwards. And Alex Dampier there with his team trailing by 3-0, getting the face off and getting his men set for some action with Jim Lynch on the left and Danny Brown on the right. Kelland, quick flick. Oh, that was a chance. Here's another chance. And it's gone through. The puck is still loose. Well, again, the net causes the play to be stopped. The puck bouncing around in front. Andy Donald has it covered, goes across, and then when he touches the net, you see, the net came away. Andy Linton is anxious on the far side of the ring to get going. He was ahead of the puck. You stay your own side of the puck when the faceoff is taken. That's Linton. Danny Brown, Brown with a snap shot. Oh, what a shot. Few occasions that Stojanovic didn't get his shot away first time. Here's Tony Hamm. Looked very much as though he's being held as he went past, and I think there will be a penalty for holding. Yes, Brian Pete is certainly going to spend 2 minutes in the box for holding there, because Hamm was almost past him. Tony Hamm here was almost past him. Now watch him. Makes a little fake, and then gets past, and then is held positively by Brian Pete. Pete will spend 2 minutes in the sin bin. For now. Murrayfield. They've had a power play. They didn't score on it. Now here's their second power play. went over the line and hit the referee. Well, that by Stuart Drummond. And Paul Pentland trying to keep it in. Not successful. Going to be picked up by Kellen. To Jim Lynch. Back to Kellen again. Two Canadians. Lynch number three. Kellen 21 carrying it. That's a good pass. Got Gordon McDougall with him. That's McDougall. Jim Lynch back to McDougall again. Pentland. That shot deflected. Still not out though. Still not out. Murrayfield keeping it in. Oh. Gordon McDougall shot just short. Pennycook taken out. Well, they've got about 45 seconds of this penalty. There's the set. Oh, great stop! A good shot by Tony Hand, and a very good stop by Andy Donald. He takes it up, and then slaps it. Well caught. So, they still have the pressure on. There's 44 seconds or so remaining, 43 to be precise. Face off again. There's 6 minutes and 37 seconds of the period to play, and there's just 28 seconds. The penalty. Paul Pentland. Murrayfield in there, but only as far as the blue line. The pass for Stojanovic. Run by McDougall. Around. Still there for Murrayfield, but deflected again. Kellen with the shot. Again it's deflected. McDougall now. Fife have played off another penalty. And Andy Donald makes another good stop. So Donald really did well under the pressure there. But now it's Fife. Back at full strength. And Ron Plum here is the player coach. And he directs the operations with some assistance from Colin Blair. He's the man who's in charge of the team. Brian Peet trying to shoot it down the boards. Still visible. There it is. Out in front. Well, Murrayfield are making some chances, but they're not taking them. And now it's Danny Brown, Andy Linton. Woof. Chance there for Stojanovic to pack one in. And still it's loose. Stojanovic couldn't get the shot away. Jim Lynch down the boards looking for Tony Hand. Callum for Murrayfield. Carrying the puck well. Tried to come in from the near side, hoping that Donald would move across to the far side of the post, but he didn't. As he comes around the net, he sees that Donald is there, and Donald would think he would normally go around the back, but Donald outthought him, and the puck shot away. So the face-off then, just outside Five Flyer zone. And it will come back into the game somewhat in the last minute or so. Here's Neil Abel. away. It's in there. Kellen floating it through. The puck is loose. There it is. Jack Hay, the scorer. So, Murrayfield get one back, and that's pleased the fans. Jack Hay. Bit of a scramble in front of the net. Bounces through there. Knocked away. And there's Jack Hay. Moves away. There's Jack Hay to poke it in. And it's... again. The puck in front. Hay comes through. 3-1. Meanwhile, we have a face-off back alongside the Murrayfield. 3-1 the score. 4 minutes and 42 seconds on this first period. And Murrayfield, as I said, were coming back into the game. They emphasized that by scoring a goal. And they get another one before the period finishes. Murray Hansen, not it well. Still the face-off there. Face-off going to be taken by the front line's captain, Gordon Latto, with Gordon McDougall. Back to the point. I still have possession. Oh, there was a chance. The puck was very loose in front, and then flicked away. Picked up now by Stuart Drummond. Playing on defense with Brian P. 21. Pass. Well, here's a man. Loose in front. It's Kenny Cook. Kenny Cook's in front. And it's there. Gordon Latto. Looked to me as though it was Gordon Latto that picked up that loose puck. So let's have a look at that again. Puck very loose. Came through. And in fact it was Chick Cottrell who tucked it away. So it's 4-1 now for Five Flyers. Just over 4 minutes left on the period. Chick Cottrell, 30 years of age, comes from Capote. Around the back. That has sent Murrayfield back a bit. They were coming back into the game. And obviously, the temperature's rising a bit. Well, Paul Hand there lost his helmet during the scrimmage along the boards. There's no penalty on the situation, so it's another face-off for Fife. 2 minutes 55, and they're leading 4-1. Another chance, there it is! Stojanovic! Number 9, Stojanovic, the man who scores. That's a new championship record. When Stojanovic puts that son away, he has scored 28 points in the championship round. Stojanovic, the top scorer in Britain, and a new championship record for the championship round. 5-1 the score, and Fife in possession, looking for Brown. Tony Hand turning it back. The time played to play in this first period. Kellen turning it back. Lindsay Lovell to Tony Hand. Tony Hand with a slap shot. Oh, that was a good one. It was just outside the post, but there was no mistake by Andy Donald. He held on to that one. Very good catch. Here's Tony Hand's slap shot. It's moving, remember, 120 miles an hour. Good stop. This lad was born in Toronto, in fact, but has lived in Capote for the last 10 years. So, we've got 3 minutes and 14 seconds on the period. Five Flyers 5, Murrayfield races 1. Jordan Letta coming into the face-off. Cottrell there. And now, Stuart Drummond turning it back. And here's far as Cottrell. Gordon Leto. Back again. Well, he's not in a hurry. He doesn't need to. Stuart Drummond. Around the boards. And flipped away. Picked up by Chris Kellen. 2.5 minutes left on the period. Paul Healy turning it back, looking for Gordon McDougall. And it's bounced out. Whoops, Lazy. Well held. Alex Dampier caught that one and popped it back. The puck was shot out of the rink. Alex Dampier there in the red sweater caught it and popped it back in again. But there'll be a face-off from where the puck was shot. And that face-off is just outside the Murrayfield Racers zone. 2 minutes and 17 seconds. Pennicott losing it. Jack Hay going after it, but Ron Crum right around the boards. That's Paul Healy. Healy to McDougall. McDougall just too far ahead of Hay. McIntyre on the boards there now. Pennicott easing the pressure. Kellen deciding to carry the puck. And he really is. He's hoping that someone was on the far side, but they weren't. And now, Danny Brown. It's there, must be. Easy. Danny Brown left it. Andy Linton scored it. Well, 6-1. Here's Danny Brown. Great mover. Beautiful skater. No effort at all. Takes it through. He's taken out of the play, but in comes Andy Linton, and it's 6-1. Well, 5-5 really flying. Well, Stojanovic turning it back. Just about a minute left to play in this period. So just a minute left to play now. Tony Hamm, that's way up into the crowd. And that is a souvenir for someone in ice hockey when the puck goes out of the rink and the person who gets it keeps it as a souvenir. Interesting that the last 3 shots on goal the 5 Flyers have all been goals. 6-1 it is. And 50 seconds. Is clearing it. New label. That's icing. Down the other end. Just 38 seconds to play. Face off in the Murrayfield end. And take the face off. Danny Brown back to Stojanovic. Well, didn't come through. Here's a chance for Tony Hamm. Didn't collect the pass. Good pass. Stojanovic on the left. He's in. Stojanovic, will he beat the goalie? No. Murray Hansen was there first. 15 seconds to play on the period. In the Murrayfield end. Forehand. And he passed. past it out. Stanovic, the Brown. The shot, it's there! Danny Brown. That's his third goal. John Hayne, the Fife manager, is very pleased with him, and Danny Brown gets a hat-trick with only 1 second left to play. Here's Brown. There's the shot. In the net, 7-1, and 1 second left to play. Remember, as soon as the clock stops, the light goes on, the clock stops, and it's as close as that, 1 second. Danny Brown, there it is, the end of the first period, and a sensational period for Fife Flyers, who lead by 7-1.
Leeds look for the third and final period, which is just underway, as you see, and Alan Weeks.
Yes, it is, quite incredibly. The score is still the same. In fact, in that second period, it was Murrayfield all the way. They, in fact, outshot Fife by 15-7. And they hit the post twice. So, Murrayfield, well, they've got a lot to do, but it has been done before. And weak stick handling. Shot deflected. Andy Linton. There's Killen. That's Neil Abel. And Randy Linton again. Here's Gordon McDougall. Murrayfield still in possession. Hard body check there by Ron Plum. And the referee is calling it an elbow. So, it looks to me as though Ron Plum, the player coach of Fife Flyers, will spend some time in the box, 2 minutes. Here's the body check. Well, the elbow came up, but not that much. However, he's getting 2 minutes for using the elbow. And Murrayfield, who prior to this match have been very good on the power play games, have not yet scored on a power play, but they have a chance now. 5 out players for Murrayfield. 1 man short for Fife. Back to the point. Here's Paul Pentland. Pentland's snap shot. Lay off. And Chris Kellerman get it, so they'll have to come out. Kellerman. Gordon McDougall. His snap shot. Well held by Andy Donald. Andy Donald did extraordinarily well in that second period when Murrayfield were keeping the pressure on him all the time. This is where the player's been, in the Fife zone, ever since that first period. But thus far, Murrayfield haven't been able to score. Tony Hand, still in possession. There's a turn. Puck is still loose. Gordon McDougall with it. Still there. Jim Lynch. Tony Hand. Looking, waiting and watching. They've got a man about it, remember. The backhand was deflected. And here's a break. Brian Peat. Long shot. Murray Hansen couldn't hold it. Around the back by Kevin. Only comes as far as Brian Peat again. Fife Flyers in there and keeping it there, that's where they want to keep it. I was going to say that teams have come back from a deficit like that because in 1982 Murrayfield were leading Dundee 8-1 and Dundee Rockets won the match by 9-8. So, Fife Flyers, shorthanded. Murrayfield with the power play. Andy Brown. Four hands. Just too far ahead of Lindsay Lovell. But Paul Hand gets it again. He travels on the right wing. This is Paul Hand, the defenseman, going through. It's there! It's there! Jim Lynch, the scorer. Paul Hand, the man who who brought the puck through. He carried it from one end to the other. And his Murrayfield supporters are back in the game, as Murrayfield have been. His tall hand carrying the puck. Takes it around one defenseman. Comes through, and it's Jim Lynch who pops it in there for 7-2. Well, that's what Murrayfield have wanted. Forest Flyers now back at full strength. And 7-2 the score. Offside. Trying. Nasty bouncer, very awkward. Oh, it's there! Very awkward indeed, and that was Stojanovic. Well, that shows you what a bouncing puck can do. Five Flyer supporters absolutely ecstatic. It took all that time for Murrayfield to get a goal, and then Stojanovic gets one back. That's his second goal of the game. Now, watch the bounce. It bounces once. Bounces again, and when it bounces there, Stojanovic flips it in. 8-2. Murrayfield now. Oh, that was a tremendous body check by Stojanovic, and Paul Heavey going after Stojanovic. There's a man off the puck, and Stojanovic, and Heavey's going after Stojanovic. It was a tremendous body check by Stojanovic by a player who wasn't involved. Heavey and Stojanovic were involved in this little fracas. That means that almost certainly Five Flyers are going to lose one of their best players for some of the time. Well, the linesmen have got them apart at last. Only just. Paul Heavey still trying. Stojanovic underneath the other linesman. Well, let's see what happens now. They've got to calm them down, cool them down before they can separate them and send them to the box. That's Paul Heavey. He's going straight to the box. Well, the Murrayfield supporters wondering about Klarinovich. He's coming across to the box now. So, we'll see how long they've got, but I must say it was Klarinovich's check which certainly laid one of the Murrayfield players low, which caused that little fracas. However, we'll now see how long they've got in the box. So the referee is still explaining to the number here.
2 minutes for elbows and 5 minutes for fighting.
Five minutes of fighting. The time of the penalties, 3 minutes, 30 seconds. That's two for elbows and five for fighting, and the nine of the Flyers, they've scrambled. Paul Heavey, five penalties, Stojanovic has got 5 minutes each for fighting, and Stojanovic is also got another penalty for using the elbow. So Stojanovic will be off from that first check, which I thought was a bit tough. He'll be off for 7 minutes in total. So both teams a man short. And Murrayfield, who really have been keeping all the pressure on, well, we'll see. Chris Kellen, the captain, is going to change the line and get Jim Lynch on. McDougal is going off, and Jim Lynch is coming on. Meanwhile, on the Fife bench, some deep discussion. So, to the point, Kellen, just off. Tony Hamm, here comes Danny Brown. Here's Kellen, giving it back. Here's Jim Lynch. Ball hand. Finds Kellen, not quick enough. Lynch. Shooting it in. Tony Hand going after it, along with Neil Abel. Abel shooting it down the boards. It's Still in there. Paul Hand keeps it in. His brother Tony's got it now. Paul Hand with it. Around the back. To Chris Killen. On the point. Beckham. An easy one for Plum to take out. And here comes Danny Brown. Brown number 19. Gordon Letter getting close. It's bounced away. That was very close indeed. Tony Hand, bit of stick handling. Still carrying that cup, a good pass back. Kellen. There's nobody behind there. It's Abel around the boards. It's Danny Brown. No, it's not. It's Jim Pinnacle. And here's Linton. Linton with a shot. Knocked away by Murray Hansen. But Hansen's out the net. Back to the point. Here's Abel. Abel with a shot. Off the net again, deflected by one of the players. So Abel comes back to pick up the shot, which is deflected by one of the players into the corner, picks it up again. Now Murrayfield in possession, Gordon McDougall. Good pass, Tony Hand. Tries the pass again, here's a chance. Oh! Well wide from Gordon McDougall. Heads down the boards, and it'll be an icing. There it is, face-off back in the Five Flyers end. Well, it really is up and down ice hockey, all the way through the second period and now in this last period. Even though the score is so far apart, the excitement is tremendous. Ron Plum, the coach of the Five Flyers team, he was voted the coach of the year by the Ice Hockey Writers Association. And in fact, Stoyanovich, who's in the box, was voted the player of the year. I must say, the crowd is tremendous. The attendance, the attendance is 7,151, which is the highest attendance of ice hockey since the 1960s. Another face-off. A bit of pushing. Having a few words with each other. Both the lines are in there very quickly. And Jim Lynch coming in for the face-off. No penalty, but there's going to be a change for Murrayfield. A poor hand has come on to the fence with Paul Pinkham. Murrayfield in possession again. McDougall. Because they shot it down the ice and he got there first. Here's a chance now for Pete with a snap shot. Oh, it's come loose again, but Hansen just gets it. There's an appeal to the referee for an infringement in front of the net, but I don't think he's going to give anything. Here's the shot. Murray Hansen sprung away, but he's sprung on it equally quickly. Murray Hansen. Well, he hasn't had as much to do in the last two periods as did Donald. In the first period, he was very busy. So, Five Flyers now. A face-off in the Murrayfield end. This is Tony Hand. Starting a skate. And going well. The shot. And just flicked away by Neil Abel. No one there to pick up the rebound. This is brother Paul Hand. Out in front. Knocked away again. Puck is still loose. Abel. Cottrell. Puck comes loose. Picked up by Gordon Leto. The Five captain. Taking his time. And a whistle. Because it looks as though the net is off its moorings. Yes, it is. It's got to be absolutely right. Well, we've got Murrayfield still keeping the play in territory of the Badgers are heading. Alex Dampier, the coach, has been doing a good job. They've certainly come back in these last two periods. 8-2 at the moment, though. Abel, down the boards. Looking for Danny Brown. Danny Brown will get it. And the face off back in the Five Flyers zone. Well, the Five Flyers really roaring their team on when they need to, because they've been under pressure for about almost 30 minutes now. Tony Hamm, brilliant stick handling, but there's been someone to cover up. Paul Hamm with a body check there, which took Jim Pinnacook out of the play. Remembering that body checking in ice hockey is legal. Unless, of course, it's against the boards. If you hit someone against the boards, could be off for boarding. Well, the top scorer in Britain, voted the player of the year, still sitting out in the box, looking up at the penalty clock to see how much longer he's going to sit there. Meantime, out on the ice, it's the Murrayfield who've been in most of the attacking. Duncan McIntyre now coming in for the face-off. Tony Hamm taking a rest as Duncan McIntyre comes out there. But Jim Pinnicott, number 7, carried a putt well. Back to the point. Brian Pete. Off the net. Here's Stuart Drummond. Here's a chance. Duncan McIntyre. There's a pass. Jack Hay. Oh, he lost the edge of his skates at the last moment. Well, that was a real chance. Jack Hay, a fellow who just quite couldn't make it. Now back come Fife. Here's Pennycock. Pennycock with a shot. Knocked away by Murray Hanson. The referee signifies that as being a dive. Oof, that was a tough body check. Now it's Drummond. So we've got about 15 seconds to the Murrayfield player, Paul Heavey, coming back on the ice. Now, a chance, Brown, just off the net. Jack Hay again. Heavey is back on the ice. So now, remember, Racers have the man advantage. They're in the power play situation. They've had 4 power plays and they've only scored 1 goal so far. Well, will Murrayfield do what everyone has been expecting and get another goal there? We've got 11 minutes and 20 seconds or so of the game. And the score is still 8-2, but now the power play is with Murrayfield. Danovich there, 1 minute and 53 seconds. There's Paul Hamm, with a shot, off the net, comes right around to Chris Kellen. Kellen floating it in, picked up by Tony Hamm, didn't get it back. That was Andy Linton shooting it down the ice. So it's picked up by Paul Hamm. Danny Brown going in after him. Jim Lynch leading it for Gordon McDougall. McDougall now up the centre. Tony Hamm still bouncing for him. Not enough. Andy Linton poked it clear. The pass. The referee. Unlucky. Paul Hamm. To Tony, but it's back out again. They've got to spread out a bit. There's the man in the clear. Now someone coming through. It's Gordon McDougall, but no one there to take the pass. Here's Paul Hamm. Shot off the net. It's there. McDougall is the man who deflected it into the net from Paul Hamm's shot. A third goal. And that's their second power play goal. Here it is. There's the shot. Deflected in there. Eight goals to three. And so, McDougal gets the goal. It's eight goals to three for Five Flyers, but now Five Flyers are back at full strength. Chris Kellen. Paul Heavey and Jim Lynch shooting it in. Just about halfway through this last period. About 10 minutes to play. And can Murrayfield get it back? Here's Tony Hand again. Some neat stick handling. The loose puck. Couldn't be passed through though. Lindsay Lovell. Jim Pennycook. He fell. Heavey. Down the board to Tony Hand, who didn't take it. Neil Abel, a slap shot. Harry Hansen, let it go because there was nobody in there. Danny Brown in there, but no, it's Stojanovic. Back to Abel. Stojanovic wide open on the left wing. There's the pass. There's Stojanovic. Danny Brown with him. Picked up by Tony Hand. Stojanovic. Oh, good shot and a good stop. Tony Hand with a good shot there. Probably just outside, but Andy Donald wasn't going to let anything get away. He held it. Here's Hand coming down. Right wing. Takes it up with the defenseman. Snaps it. And Andy Donald had it. Face off in that. Five Flyers end. Murrayfield still keeping the pressure on. Kellum. Stojanovic just floating it in. Now, Fife. Oh, what a chance! And Stojanovic! Oh, good stop! But the goal is well out of his net. Out comes Gordon McDougall. Jack Hay. In front was Duncan McIntyre, but it's shot away again. This is Andrew Linton. But Chris Cullen has it. Cullen still taking it forward. Cullen, the Murrayfield captain. Ooh, what a body check. Man Pete. And Stojanovic. This is Linton. Linton with a shot. Well wide. Chance again as Chris Cullen sets up another play by Murrayfield. McDougall taken out. A shot. And underneath Andy Donald. Well, he's really struggling, and as he did in the second period, he's playing very well indeed. Shot through. Comes to Paul Hand. Hand takes it in and then slaps it. He's got it though. Well, we've got about 7.75 minutes of this game to play, and still the score is 8-3 in favour of Five Flyers. And Five are actually just shooting that puck down the ice to relieve the pressure that Murrayfield are putting on. Icing, and a face-off at the other end. Alex Dampier having a look up at that clock. Seconds are ticking away, although Murrayfield are having all the territorial advantage, they're just not putting that puck in the net. Coming in now for the face-off. Jim Pennycook and Tony Hand on the left. Still there, and it's still loose. Now the goalie has it. Mixed up amongst the player skates, but he got it clear. McDougall is in there. Now, I've got Les Lovell. And we've got the face-off. Tony Hand. That's okay, it didn't go over the line. He's got to wait. because there are players in beyond that blue line. He waited. It's all right now, but the pass wasn't good. Here comes Jim Pennicott, chasing it. Paul Pentland now from Murrayfield. Not a good pass. Ron Plum. Ron one. Needs to turn away. Cut by Paul Ham. Left now for Tony Ham. Nate, he still has it. Shot. Oh, good stop. Well, Tony Ham carried it beautifully down the ring. What a great player this boy is going. He's only 17. He's a super player. Watch the stick handling. Round of one man. Takes it up to the defenseman. Takes a look. Has a shot. And Andy Donald has it clear. Tony Ham, 17 years of age. Face off end that. Five Flyers end. Still there. McDougal, there it is! Jack Hay gets it at last. Well, the fans from Murrayfield happy that Jack Hay has put it away at last. It's 8-4 now. Well, Murrayfield have been keeping the pressure on, and here's the pass. Beautiful pass. Beautiful goal. Jack Hay from Gordon McDougall, and that's 8-4. 6 minutes or so left on the game, and can Murrayfield get any more back? Shot out, kept in, still there. Gordon McDougall, good pass! Oh, what a chance for Jack Hay to make it two. Oh, still bouncing, it's still in there. Two men fell over there. McDougal. Duncan McIntyre to McDougal. Got Hay going around the far side. That's Kelland. Back to McDougal again. Oh, well, last Flyers managed to get the puck out. And not very far. Paul Heavey taking it back for Murrayfield. Just floating it in. Andy Donald's going to hold it to relieve the pressure. Well, the pressure's really been on this boy now for about 35 minutes. It's a tough place to be, but it's not tough on the bench. And watch this. Here's the chance for Jack Hay to put it away. Look, he's all by himself, and it was just outside. However, it's still 8-4. Forehand. Tony Hand. Jim Lynch. Still Murrayfield keeping it up. In that five end. Puck is loose. Letter trying to get it clear. He doesn't. The referee did a bit of clever stuff. Getting out of the way. Alexis William, the referee, with the red armbands, the other two officials on the linesman. So, getting down to about the last 5 minutes now. 5 minutes and 26 seconds to be precise. Ron Plum. Only as far as Paul Hand. Hand shot. Bouncing around from Fife, Jim Pennicott. With forechecking, Gordon Netto, but broken up again by the Murrayfield defence. Since that first period, the Fife forwards have not really been showing their class. Now, Paul Ham. Oh, what a chance! Oh, dear, oh dear, what a mistake! What a mistake! Jim Pennicott, the boy who scored it, and the Fife fans are so, so pleased. What a mistake, though, by Paul Ham. Well, he got around behind him, and between the legs, there's the goal. And tall hand on the right there. Must be feeling really sick now. 9-4. It is for Five Flyers. Now Five coming forward again. Drummond with the shot. Levy to McIntyre. McDougal. Jack Hay, written out of the play by Danny Brown. Face off. 4 minutes and 20 seconds. And that goal against the run of the play by Flyers, I would say, would have taken some of the steam out of Murrayfield, but Ron Plumbier won't be too unhappy about that. However, it's still in that Five Flyers end. Another face off. Five are going to try and keep possession and Plum crazy, and it's Ron Plum that they're talking about, and they are the Concordian fans who support Five Flyers. Well, they've only got about 4 minutes and 13 seconds to wait before the final hooter. But it's the face-off in the Five Flyers end. Jim Lynch and Danny Brown facing off. Lynch has it. It's come out. Andy Linton, Stojanovic coming in. Stojanovic, good stop. He's offside. Just offside. So the play will be just outside. Stojanovic just offside. The puck was over the line behind his skates. So, Five Flyers changing their lines. Stojanovic taking a rest. There's 4 minutes. I should think he'll probably take a rest for a couple of minutes and then come on for the last 2 minutes. Harry Hansen. Down the boards by Paul Pentland to turn your hand. He's got it again. Bit mixed up there. Paul Pentland with a shot. Neil Abel shooting it away. And this will be an icing and a face-off back at the other end. So, Murrayfield once again will be down in that 5 miles in. However, you can no doubt hear the roars of the Concordia fans. And Hank Dopey was looking up at them. About 3.5 minutes. Murrayfield keeping up the pressure. That's no good. It's picked up by Gordon Leto. Leto's shot. Benson. Cleared away by Paul Pentland. Kept in though by Neil Abel. Killen around the back. Good forechecking there by Jim Pennybone. Still loose. Pentland. It's gone over the blue line. They'll have to come out. Abel. Back to Plum. Still there. Well, amongst that lot was the linesman. The puck trapped, a face off, and out come both teams. Jim Pennycook there going in, with Gordon Leto, the captain, and Chip Cottrell. Three very experienced Scottish players. Well, they've got a face off here, and what happened? It was the linesman who got slapped. So, the stick came up and hit him just under the right shoulder blade. So, Gordon Perry, he's fit again. Face off just outside now, the Five Flyers zone. the time remaining on the game. Well, here's a chance. Andy Linton going first. Murray Hansen got there first, but he's way out of his net. Here's a chance. Gordon McDougall. Hansen back in front. And Andy Linton was there. And Murray Hansen was quick out of the crease. Well, that certainly was a chance again. He was quick. He had it and he smothered it. Murray Hansen has not been as busy as Andy Donald. Well, Murray field out again, but ooh! Stuart Crummer. It's gone loose. It's still there. Well, it did come loose, but the referee had blown. So, well, Alex Dampier, in his last match as coach as Murrayfield Ball, was looking up at that clock, which shows about 2 minutes and 22 seconds, and his team trailing by 9-4. And Flyers in possession. Away by Hansen, he's trapped it again. Well, Murrayfield just don't want to concede another one, but they're desperate to get it out of that end because the pressure at last is being put on them again. Stojanovic is out there, Danny Brown is out there, and it's Chris Cutter who flakes it down the ring. Tony Hand going after it. So was Jack Hay. The pass is Stojanovic. What a shot from the first time. That's not Murray Hansen. 2 minutes left to play. Stuart Drummond. Well stopped again by Murray Hansen. Didn't get much of a side of it. Well, he took a deep breath there. He deserves it. Because now Fife have really come back and started putting the pressure on this Murrayfield side. There's no doubt the Fife Flyers are the best supported team in the country. They average about 3,000 a game at their home rink. So, the face-off. They're all getting down around the plexiglass that surrounds the rink. But there's a red light at the fire in the rink. The goal judge calling the referee. He's wondering about the net. Well, the net is in position again. Right, we'll get a face-off now in Murrayfield Racers End. And we've got about 1 minute and 49 seconds to play. Fife in possession. Ron Plum with the shot. Again, it's held by Murray Hansen. Not going to give anything away. Face-off after face-off as Fife keep the pressure on. Well, it's quick to the point. Here's a chance. Good stop by Hansen. It's underneath him. Fife keeps making save after save as Fife keep the pressure on. In this third period, Fife have had 20 shots. And Murrayfield have only had 12, so Fife have really come back in these last 4 or 5 minutes. So Dave Stojanovic is conducting the crowd with only 1.5 minutes left. Cup bouncing. Bouncing again. It's followed by Paul Hand. Now Tony Hand. Meets to Candy, good pass. Paul Hand. Gordon McDougall back to forehand, shot, knocked away. Murrayfield still have possession. Tony Hand. And here's a break. No, it's not. Forehand broke it. Well, that's a chance for Tony Hand. Now it's Murrayfield with the pressure on Fife. Back to the point. Chris Kellen. The puck is still loose. Here's another chance. Forehand. Through. Well held by Andy Donald. He had that beautifully covered. Here's the shot. Came through. Donald saw it all the way. seconds now, slowly ticking away on Murrayfield. Fife looking very happy indeed. Play in that Fife end. But you've only got about 45 seconds to go, and they know it. Murrayfield. Going even into the corner. That'll be picked up by Stuart Drummond. But Andy Linton out front. Linton stopped by Heavey. Icing. Another face off back in the Fife end. And just about 32 seconds remaining. Well, they reckon that those 32 seconds aren't necessary. The face-off. 31 seconds on this Heineken Championship match. Murrayfield in possession. Tony Ham. Kept in by Heavey. It's out now. It's Stojanovic moving fast. And he just skidded away. Round by Kellen. They're counting down the seconds now. Stojanovic just holding the puck, waiting. There it is. Fife Flyers are the Heineken champions. 9-4. Well, they were runners-up in the Autumn Cup. They were runners-up in the league, but now they are the Heineken champions. Fife Flyers, 9-4. Tremendous scenes in Wembley Arena. It really takes you back to the old days of ice hockey. Stojanovic down there, and now the players go through their normal procedure at the end of a match. A lot of congratulations amongst themselves, but in ice hockey, the teams always shake hands with their opponents. It might have been a hard game, tough for Murrayfield. They tried hard in that second period, but everyone will shake hands, everyone will congratulate the others, and that's one of the things about ice hockey. You see it at the end of every match. They might have been tough, they might have been rough, but at the end, they've enjoyed a good game. And there's no doubt that the crowd here at Wembley has enjoyed a good game. Well, the Alex Dampier, the Murrayfield coach, has come out onto the ice there. He is congratulating the Fife players. There he is. He's congratulating the Fife players. His last game as coach for Murrayfield Racers. He's had a very distinguished career. He's going to go to Nottingham Panthers next season. And now we're getting ready for the presentation. 9-4 it was for Fife Flyers. Remember, it was 7-1 at the end of the first. No score in the second. And so that trophy will be presented by Mr. Peter DeLonga, the International Director of Heineken. And that trophy will go to the captain of Fife Flyers, a very, very experienced Scottish player. The captain is Gordon Latto. And so, Gordon Latto waiting to go forward and collect. There he goes. That'll be the proudest moment of his career. Gordon Latto, captain of Fife Flyers, receives the Heineken Championship Trophy. Fife Flyers are the Heineken champions. And doesn't that crowd love it? A marvellous moment. Gordon Latto. It's a Five Flyers, runners-up in the Autumn Cup, runners-up in the league, but now, the Heineken champions, Five Flyers.
So the rain still falling heavily here at Celtic Park as the second half gets underway. Rangers still out delighted to go in half-time with that one goal lead, particularly after taking such a rubbing early in the match. The defence stood firm and gave encouragement to the rest of the side to fight back. And here's David Coleman for Celtic. Missed by Maurice Johnston in the air and then by Brian McLean.